Thank you all very much, and welcome to the EMU Chamber Singers Concert for Spring 2023. We're very excited to be here with you this evening. I'll get into more of the theme and some introductions in a little bit. We started off with Wake Up My Spirit by a local Virginian professional composer, Adolphus Hailstork. And we'd like to also start off with a song that we sing together. So if you would like to do that, I invite you to turn in Voices Together, the Purple Hymnal, to number six. Number six, Let's Walk Together. Thank you. Well, it has been a big semester for us, and we are only halfway through, even though technically it's finals week this next week, because the EMU Chamber Singers has been a part of two large tours this semester, comprising of some two dozen concerts. And this is our only full-length one in Harrisonburg. So thank you for coming. We're excited to share it on home soil. As we were thinking about the tour, to the Midwest that we did in the spring break, which was to Ohio and Indiana, and looking ahead to our Europe tour, which we leave for in 8 days. I was thinking about what kinds of things we could plan around for those tours. And so one idea was to take a bit of home with us. And so sharing a few tastes of our area. And so this first half includes songs by local composers, songs that have their genesis in this area, or even just allude to the Shenandoah Valley in general. And so that's where we start with this first one, which is one that is quite ubiquitous and fairly well known, oftentimes the tune O Shenandoah. And this beautiful arrangement is by James Erb.
Thank you.
The next three songs written by local composers all have the composers in this space, which is very exciting for us. This first one is A New Leaf by Bradley Lehman, a composition written in 2019, and this is the first time that it's been performed in the Valley since its composition because of that pesky thing that happened in 2020. And Brad Lehman also happens to be the father of one Afton Rhodes Lehman in the choir. And Brad wrote about the genesis of this piece as such. The words are from two chopped up poems by John Donne and Emily Dickinson, 250 years apart. Time passes, or maybe it doesn't. Emily Dickinson's whole poem about a woodpecker only has 23 words, and we get three of John Donne's 12 stanzas. Those are about breaking out of old bad habits because you promised God to do better. In an idea from Isaiah 55, put your resources where there will be worthwhile results. You promised God you can do better, so have a goal. Don't just beat your head repeatedly on hard things with no results. A woodpecker's work has purpose. The music stays in one scale, C minor, the whole time. There are no sharps, except for the woodpecker's bill, which is an auger. And most of the John Donne parts are like a slow chant, with notes and crunchy clusters from that C minor scale. The silent times, or rests, are as important as the scale intervals. Things happen in silences, in patterns and habits. Some old habits never go away. Trees are hard. We try to keep working on things that matter, like the hungry woodpecker, and time passes, or maybe it doesn't.
Have seats and books over my utmost goal.
And our next piece, Eagle's Wings, by Sam Kaufman, alumni of EMU in class of 2012. This is a setting of Isaiah 40's beautiful message of encouragement and strength, rich with text painting, mixed mode harmonies, and a contrasting middle section that Sam calls excessive parallelism, where the parts move together in the same direction. The tenor and bass version of this piece was originally premiered by the EMU Chamber Singers in 2011 when both Sam and I were a part of the ensemble, and this is the premiere of the SATB version, soprano, alto, tenor, bass version.
Hast thou not known?
one more closing out this local section, which was added to our Midwest tour. So close to the tour, it didn't even make it into the program. And so we got to surprise everyone on tour about this song that we commissioned of the Walking Roots Band, a local band, and specifically Greg Yoder, for a song to a bit of a vague prompt, I suppose. I don't know, he could say how it was received, but to think about our new major that we added a couple years ago called Music and Peace Building, an interdisciplinary style major, of which we have a couple people here, Maggie in the choir, and I guess maybe a couple others here. Ray's here, I think. Just thinking about how music is a tool in building peace. And so this is the song that he came up with and was a lot of fun to take on tour and very special to finally bring home, because now all three of these folks who have had a peace premiere here, this is the first time they're hearing all three of those in live. So that's pretty special and fun too. So glad you can join in that experience with us. This is Sing Each Other Home.
Thank you.
And if you know of anyone who might be interested in that kind of a major, it's very exciting and growing. In fact, by next year, a quarter of the department will be music and peacebuilding majors. And we move into now a section that where we take songs that we have learned from elsewhere, outside of the Shenandoah Valley, specifically the globe, which leaves us a lot of room to encounter a lot of ideas and songs and sounds and languages. And so we start with, if I can find the translation, Sigalagala, which translates to the shepherd. The high priest is passing by. Come and see my Lord. Yes, Jesus is passing by. Come and see him. He's calling. Come, we all go to heaven. Jesus has brought salvation. Let there be ululation. He's brought forgiveness. Let there be ululation. Only through him can there be salvation. Let there be ululation. This next one would not be found in the program, as it has also come later, is a song in Arabic called Lau Rahal Soti, and the general translation is, if my voice departs, your voices will not. I look unto tomorrow, and my heart is with you. If the singer dies, the songs will remain, bringing together the broken and suffering hearts.
Thank you.
Mothers of Brazil. This powerful piece was originally written for instruments by Lars Jansen and then arranged for chorus by Gunnar Eriksson for performance in Brazil. Eriksson dedicated his arrangement to the mothers of Brazil and mothers everywhere who bring back their children from unnecessary wars. Eriksson chose to use the text Salve Regina, as many humans call out in times of need for mothers. And so the translation of the Latin that's used reads, Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. Queen of Heaven, rejoice. Alleluia. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, and Jesus, the blessed fruit of thy womb.
Thank you.
and closing out the set of global songs, a song by Isai Marie Barnwell of the famous group Sweet Honey and the Rock called Prayer. Looking at the golden rule from its alternative, O Lord, must I do unto others before they do unto me? No, that's not what I learned on my mother's knee when she told me to do unto others only what I would have them do unto me. So this is prayer. Before our closing song and then a benediction, just have a few thank yous. First off, to Parkview for allowing us to use this beautiful space and for hosting us for this concert. Thank you. And to you all for coming this evening, for your support in enjoying the music with us. That's a big reason we do what we do. For supporting us in this way, we also covet your prayers as we travel in a week. We'll be in Western Europe for 2 weeks, and looking forward to some good music, some good host families from some Mennonite churches, some beautiful cathedrals, and a bit of sightseeing. So we do have some funds to raise, so if you would like to drop some money on your way out, there's a basket. There's also a QR code on the back of the programs if you would like to give that way. But we also just appreciate your support here this evening. There are also three seniors. This is always a sad time of year. I try to forget it, but then that's also not nice to the seniors. So I would like to have just step forward Philip Crable, Bryn Yoder, and Andrew Zook to these three gentlemen who have been wonderful parts of chamber singers across, for two of them across their 4 years, and to Andrew for finally finding us his senior year. It was a good year to join, a lot of good tours. So thank you to these three, and best wishes in merry go. close with, before our benediction at least, we close with a song, Ain't No Grave Can Hold My Body Down, an exciting 20th century arrangement of the refrain attributed to the 20th century South. And this particular arrangement by Caldwell and Ivory includes a section that uses American Sign Language, and so it's a powerful addition to a piece to experience a song as those who are deaf and hard of hearing experience as well. So this is Ain't No Grave Can Hold My Body Down.
Thank you.
Again, thank you, thank you, thank you. We leave you with, go ye now in peace.